Thursday morning. Our guest host today, Leisa Roles, has recently returned from Afghanistan, where she produced a special report for us here on The Circle about the Aussie ladies who are serving over there. Leisa, I've got to ask you, why did you choose to focus on women?
Well, there are 1,550 troops over there and only 57 women. So back here, you know, we always see the men. We don't see much of what the Australian women are doing. So we figured while we were there and we had that great opportunity, we'd go out and have a look at them and see what they're doing on the job.
Because it's always such a different topic, isn't it, to talk about? No matter how far we progress in terms of equality, when we think of war, we don't think of women and we don't think of mums.
Especially serving in the armed forces. Yeah. Let's have a look.
There may not be many women on the front line in Afghanistan, but they're there mostly behind the scenes. While men may be flying the Chinooks, it's Melissa Thompson who has their backs on the ground. At Mission Support, she's the one coordinating their operation, staying on the air while they're in the sky.
It gets pretty full on with the communication and the tasking.
It's a job she loves.
It's not just a career, it's like your lifestyle.
And her workmates are now her family, but loved ones are rarely out of mind nor out of sight when it comes to young mum Leisa Jordan.
That's when I went home on holiday and he was 2.5.
She's left her young son to play mother to the Chinook crew, taking care of everything from paperwork to staff. But the constant reminders of what, or more importantly, who she's missing are tough.
It reminds me of why I'm here every day. So.
Why is that?
I'm here because it's something that he can be proud of when he's older.
Do you have your times when you cry?
Yeah, a lot. I cry a lot, actually.
And life behind a desk doesn't mean she's out of danger. Australia's base at Kandahar Airfield has the most rocket attacks of any in Afghanistan, an average of up to 5 a week. She was there in July when a building took a direct hit.
It frightened me for a moment, but ultimately we were just lucky that no one was in the building at the time and everyone got away safe.
Leisa's counting the days until she goes home in October, just in time for her son's 3rd birthday.
Getting to know him all over again, so that's what I'm looking forward to.
Taryn Ovenden has a long way to go. She landed in Afghanistan 4 days after her 21st birthday and had been there 2 weeks when we met her.
Very intense. It's, painful some days.
Taryn's a flight technician, part of a team keeping Australia's spy planes in the air.
My dad used to be in the Air Force doing what I'm doing now, so I just sort of grew up with it.
But here, she's doing it in 50-plus degree heat.
Is there a presumption that maybe you're female, you're not quite as mechanically switched on as the flights?
Yeah, there is that, but you just got to sort of, you got to sort of prove yourself.
Nissa Wiley has more than proved it. She's showing up the blokes. At 20, she's spending a gap year running the spare parts department for Australia's Chinooks.
What's housed in here?
Just all our spare parts for the aircraft, so everything from O-rings to transmissions.
In fact, when she's done, she plans on studying graphic design. But right now, she's the go-to girl for prying spare parts out of the hands of the US and British when they don't necessarily want to give them up.
They certainly do a job as well, if not better, than a lot of the guys do.
They can do it tough.
What's the longest you've been without showers?
A running shower, I'd say about 2.5 weeks. A bird bath, about 5 days, which sounds disgusting, but it's the army.
Oh,
it is disgusting.
I went 5 days.
Oh, I went 5 days, and I walked into the bathrooms on the remote patrol base and went, okay, I'm not going to. I'll do baby wipes and Rexona, and that was it for me for 5 days. I finally had to give in after a very sweaty day out.
And it's 50 degrees.
50 plus. It was 57 degrees.
Oh.
One afternoon we were sitting there going, oh, God, it's hotter than it's been. And they said, no, 57 degrees.
Can I ask you, I was watching that and that the poor woman who's without her son. Mm. I could never do that, not in a million years. I mean, that is an amazing woman. Why do these women do it? Is it mad patriotism or a sense of duty?
I think there's a sense of duty, but it's their job. You know, that woman, Leisa Jordan in particular, said, I want my son to be proud of me. And she also made the point that luckily for her, he was young enough that he probably won't remember mum being away. But, you know, it's tough for her. And she teared up while we were talking to her.
Of course.
And I was away from my children at that time. So looking at her wall of photos, you know, made me sort of a bit,
It's such an important story to show because I've never thought sort of as women being on the front line as much as they are, but mothers. I've never contemplated that there's mothers over there missing their kids.
And she's a single mum. So Her little boy's at home, Luke, he turns 3 in December. So he's at home with her mother and his dad, sort of, you know, sharing the parenting responsibilities.
Afghanistan, of course, has been in the news, particularly this week. Last night, the ABC aired footage showing electoral fraud at last week's Afghan election, and they had this mobile phone footage, and basically you could see campaign workers filling out dozens of stolen ballot papers.
Wow.
Now, you've been there. Does that surprise you at all that it's that corrupt when it comes to an election?
There was always that fear that there would be corruption, and I did some research. They've had more than 4,000 complaints of electoral rigging since the election. The results won't. Preliminary results should come out hopefully within the next week, but they won't really know until the end of October who wins. But you know, more than 4,000 complaints, and that's just the people who are game enough to go and lodge a complaint, that aren't too terrified of the Taliban to go and say, hey, look, I think something went wrong here.
You just feel so sorry for the people there that are trying to get some level, any level of democracy would be wonderful for them. And you also covered a story early this week about an email that came from an Aussie soldier who's serving in Afghanistan. What did he reveal in the email?
His email was very scathing. His email was sent from the front line to a friend in Australia, another soldier, and it was leaked through the media, which the defence weren't happy about. Of course, the Australian Defence have defended it, but they were accused of not providing adequate support, either air support or intelligence support, to troops who are in a battle where one of our Australian soldiers died.
I saw excerpts of that email. It was really honest. It was really a discussion between two friends, and I don't know too much about the military, but I believe the troop. I believe what he was saying. Because a lot of times in any organisation, the guys at the top really don't know what it's like to be on the ground, whether that's at the office or, you know, if in Afghanistan. So it's a bit of a worry.
Leisa, would you go back?
I would. I don't think my family would be too happy to hear that. But if I don't go back, other journalists, we have to keep going back, because otherwise, you know, audiences at home, when people at home don't know what's going on. Yeah. And it's interesting you say about believing the trooper or the soldier's email. The defence went to great lengths to say this is one man's perception of what went on. And if you're in a foxhole and you're fighting for your life, it's not always going to be possible to know what's going on across the entire battlefield. So, in fairness, that's what the defence is saying.
Well, thank you so much for doing our special report for The Circle. It was really intriguing and such an important story for us to get across. It was great.
Thank you.
Fascinating stuff. Now let's hear from Marianne.